Hello, creators and animators. Morris here with another problem-solving tutorial for you. And today I'm going to show you how you can animate stripes or trilines, whatever you want to call them. And let me show you an example of what we're going to make right now. Wow, that was really amazing. Well, not really amazing, but if this is the kind of thing you're wanting to make, I'm going to show you how right now. So let's jump right in. For that example, I did put a lot more work into it, and we are going to make it a little more stripped down, but we can add a camera and do different things to give it some style and some kinetic movement, just to kind of give it a little something extra. But before we get to that, it's going to start off looking something like this. Now, how did I get my lines and curves looking so perfect and straight? Well, I didn't start out in After Effects. I started over here in Illustrator. And if you don't have Illustrator downloaded, or if you are having trouble making these, if you look in the description, you'll see there's a download link, and I have several line examples that you can just download in the Illustrator file. And then that way you can bypass this whole step here if you want to do it just for kind of for testing purposes. So we start by creating a new document. Our final comp is going to be 1080p, but we want a document size that is larger so that we can animate the camera and move around. So let's go with a 4K. Another thing you'll want to do is go over here to settings and go to this transparency grid and turn that off. Otherwise, you'll get those little checkerboards that kind of drive me nuts. So here we are, and if you hit the letter L, that is your ellipse tool, and we'll want to go ahead and turn the fill off, and we can leave the stroke on, but we can go ahead and bump that up to 3 or 4 or something like that, so we can see what we're doing. And if you shift, click, and drag, it will draw a perfect circle for you and drag out to about there. Hit the letter V, and if you hold the Option or Alt, you can drag, and now you've just duplicated that. And if you hit the backslash, or you go over here, that is your line segment tool. And all we have to do is shift and drag, and that creates a line for us. So we kind of have all of our elements here. And now we just need to piece these together to make something that we want. So if you hit the letter C, that's going to bring up your scissor tool. And let's go ahead and just cut this to pieces. And what we've done is basically that. So might as well do it over here too. And I'm only gonna get rid of this one section, and we'll get back to that in a moment. That's how we're gonna make a little loop-de-loop type thing that you saw on the demo. So let me drag this over here so we can kind of come in from the left. And if you go over here to view, you'll want to make sure that Snap to Point and Smart Guides is turned on. And that way when you drag your segments together, you'll see that it'll snap to it, but it'll also kind of tell you that the points are connected. And kind of drag down a little bit here. And then we're going to drag this up. And then we're going to drag these two right here. Let's make them a little smaller because we're starting to run out of space. In fact, I'll need to drag all this and just kind of go up a little. So let me drag this a little further out so we don't have a problem with these lines all intersecting. And then we grab this and drag it right here. And then we want to go ahead and join these. So if you hit Command or Control J, if we get the line segment tool, we drag that out to here. And then we select these and hit Command or Control J. Let me zoom in just a little bit. And then let me just drag this down here. That looks good. Hit the letter A, we can drag that out a little bit. Then we just grab one of these pieces here. With the letter V, Option click and drag to right there. Option click, drag that. Drag these two here. I'm sort of just making this up as I go. And let's just go ahead and end this thing, and we'll drag it off screen. And so if you twirl down this layer, you see all these line segments. We need to put them all together. If you hit the layer, it kind of selects all of them. And you hit Command or Control J, it will join them and create one line. Okay, so we are done here. And now if you hit Command or Control C, It will copy that to the clipboard. Okay, so we are back over here in After Effects, and we're going to create a new comp. We'll just make this 5 seconds. And we want this to be 4K. And let me just change the background to that. Let's go to Layer, New, Null Object. And we'll just call this Driver. Let me right click, go to Transform, Auto Orient. We want to turn that on because it's off by default. We hit the letter P and then do Command or Control V. And that pastes it in. Command Shift H. And we can see this. And you'll see that it's going from right to left. And since all of our keyframes are already selected anyway, we go here to Keyframe Assistant and we go to Time Reverse Keyframes. All you have to do is grab this last keyframe. Let me just drag it out for the full 5 seconds. And now all we need to do is create this first stripe, and everything from there will be kind of copying and pasting and duplicating, things like that. And it's going to be much easier once we get the first one done. So let me duplicate that. Command or Control D, and I'll just say line 1, and I'm going to parent line 1 to the driver. And we still have these position keyframes. I need to go ahead and turn that off, but this null is not going to give us the stripe. And so the next step for this null is we need to go to Effect, Expression Control, and Point Controller. And what a point control is, basically, it just has these simple coordinates here, X and Y, and you can parent things to it, or you can parent things, some other object or layer, to this either way. And we're going to add an expression to this, and this is going to be a two comp. So basically, it's this right here. And what this is saying is you have a variable, and the way you know it's a variable is because it's got an equal sign, and it's also got the semicolon at the end. You have to have both of those. And so we're calling up this layer. So this variable is going to go call up to the comp. What this will tell the point controller is that wherever the position of the anchor point is in the comp, that is what the coordinates we want printed out. So I don't know if that makes sense or not, but that's what we're going to do. We go up here and hit Option Stopwatch. Type L equals this. Let me do L dot to comp L dot anchor point parentheses and then enter. Okay. And you'll see that it's exactly the same as what the position value of the driver is. And this is what is going to dynamically animate the line. So go here to Layer, New Solid. We type Stripe 1. Okay. Then we go to Effect, Generate Right On. And let me break some of this down here for you. You've got your X, Y position coordinates, which are going to come in handy in a moment. You have your color value. And we're just going to go ahead and change that to, I don't know, green or something. Brush size, let's change that to 25. Hardness goes up to 100. Opacity, we will not touch. Let me explain stroke length and brush spacing here in just a moment. Don't worry about these properties here. And then we want to do this on transparent, and that brings us back to our original color. So this brush position needs to be keyframed or parented to something. And in this case, we're going to parent it down here to this point controller, and it too has the same coordinates as the driver, and you'll see that animates on perfectly. And now we have something here. And so I would say that's the hard part is kind of done, and all we need to do is create our other stripe. You can create as many as you want, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. We're gonna do 3. What I'll do is duplicate these. So I'll hit Command or Control D, then kind of drag this up just for organizational reasons, and then we can also change the color of these two to yellow. So this one's already called line 2. We don't need to do anything to it. I'm going to hit double E to reveal my expression. Go down here. And this stripe here, we just need to rename it to stripe 2. And you'll notice that the expression still has it parented to the line 1. So if you have your effects control tab open up here and you select line 2, you can just grab the pick whip, drag it up here. And now you'll see that I have stripe 2 is parented to line 2. So let's do this one more time. I will grab these two, hit Command or Control D, drag up, and it's already conveniently named for us. I'm going to hit double E to reveal my expression. Go down here and again drag the pick whip from our stripe 3 up to the line 3 null, and there's that. So I will recolor those to green. And so now you will get to see exactly why we rigged this the way we did. With parenting and expressions, looking at anchor points, we still have our positions on our nulls that are completely unaffected, even though the write-on effect is parented to these nulls. So basically, I can go over here and let's change this to 75. Change this to negative 75. And so that is an easy way to create these stripes or lines. And if we wanted to go and, let's say, drag this into a new comp, let's change this comp size back down to 1080. Turn this into a 3D layer. We go to Layer, New Camera. And if we right-click on the camera, go down to Camera, and do a create null orbit, it will create a null object and parent the camera to that null object. Let's see, so we start right here. Let me hit the stopwatch. Let's go out a few frames. Let's go out like a second, let's say. Then drag the null down here and go out another second, get this null and just kind of drag it wherever you need to go to next. Stay right there, and then not much is going on there. Then drag that right there, drag it again up here, and go over here, and then it goes off screen and we watch it. This is not very elegant looking at all, but I don't want to become a complete perfectionist. I wanted to basically just show you the basic idea of how you can follow these lines along a little ways, and you can be as precise as you want to be. And if you want to add a little bit more style to it, you can go over here to adjustment layer. And let's say you don't like that color, you can always go here to effect, generate, fill, and let's just change that to let's just go to a white. I know that's not much of anything, but and then because then we're gonna go over here to stylize and glow. And to turn the threshold up on that a little bit, you can do other things like perspective and a drop shadow to maybe give a little something, pull the distance out a little ways. And if you want to take this a little bit further, you can always grab all this and you can select all your layers and then go here to layer, pre-compose. And then we need to create a new background layer. So I'm just gonna go with the same background. Then I can drag in this dust and scratches footage that I found. You'll wanna change your blend mode to add or screen if you wanna get rid of the black. And I'll provide a link down below on where you can get this footage because I thought it came in handy. And it just kinda adds a little something to it and makes it not look quite so clean and perfect, you know? Let me go back and explain stroke length and brush spacing to you real quick. This could be kind of cool looking also, if you want it to be. So here's our stroke length and our brush spacing in seconds as we see here. What this tells you is how long will this stroke length go out before the end of this stroke follows along, okay? It's probably better if I just show you. Let me change this to 0.5 seconds. And now you see the end of that stroke going along exactly 1/2 of a second later, the tail end of that stroke follows along. And of course we have to do this on all of these. So let's do like 0.7 on this one here. And then on this other one here, we'll do 0.5. Let me do 0.4. Try in this. So there's that. I don't like these other colors. Just gonna change this to yellow. Change this to whatever that is. And I'm gonna change this last one to this purple here. And the other thing I want to show you, and I'm just going to do it on this one here, is the brush spacing. Basically, right on is like a brush stroke. And if you worked with Illustrator or Photoshop or whatever, you know that they're nothing more than just circular blobs or whatever. And depending on the dynamics you have set up on your brush, that's what we have going on here. So what we have is 0.001 going on here. So let's say if we go to 0.1 here. And that's a little bit much. Let me go with 0.08 or something. Okay, so now we have that. Let me go back over here to this. Let me change the background color. And then I need to go over here to my adjustment layer, turn off the fill, go back over here. And I just went ahead and cut out the ramp preview. And so this is what we have now. And it's something a little more funkier looking. So there's that. So there are several different things you can do in the write-on effect to give it some different looks. And let's say you want to make more of these stripes. You can always go over here to your first stripe layer and duplicate that, open it up, and you can go down here to the driver, and I can just hit the stopwatch to delete all those keyframes. Let me lock all the rest of this down so I'm just working with the driver, and I can hit the stopwatch. And let's say we go 3 seconds out, and then let me just kind of drag across here and maybe go a second in and kind of make that go like so. This is what I like best about this, is that it's completely dynamic, and because we've already done all the rigging, all we have to do is go in here and change our keyframes any way we want them to, and it will work. So anyway, if you found this helpful, please give me a like or subscribe down below, and I try to create tutorials as often as possible. Thank you so much, and have fun animating.